One of the most important changes to the theme, though, is that it is now responsive. Notice how when we shrink the screen down, certain interface elements change and the layout adjusts. So as we get a little bit smaller, you can see that one of the first changes is right here when the tab here becomes a pill-shaped button. Buttons are easier to press on smaller device screens, and they also cascade to multiple lines more easily. As we get a little smaller, the next change we see is where the blocks in the left-hand column get merged with the main column, and the layout becomes a single column. Once it's in a single column, the main layout doesn't really need to change anymore, but as we become even smaller, at some point the navigation turns into a mobile navigation menu here, with the standard icon for mobile interface. If we click it, it might be a little hard if we're an administrator and see this overlay, but when we do, we see the menu drop down here and we can click items within it. Okay, I'm going to collapse the menu, and then we'll expand the browser again, and you can see the change here from the mobile menu back to the pill-shaped buttons. And then as we expand back out, the layout will shift into the two-column version, and then at some point we'll get our tabs back. Now the point of responsive design like this is to enable us to use the site on multiple sizes of screens. So if you opened up this Drupal 8 site on a mobile device, for example, it would be very functional because the layout will collapse to fit the screen size. In Drupal 7, by default, the layout was fixed. So if we expand the screen here to the full size, you can see that right about here, which is at 960 pixels wide, our Drupal site is at full width. We can expand out and you can see some space shows up on the side. And then as we collapse, the content starts to drop off to the side. This means that in order to get to the content to the side, we actually have to horizontally scroll one way or the other. In a desktop browser, that might not be a big deal, but on a mobile browser, that's a huge pain.